Rebel troops from the 61st Mobile Infantry, also known as Twilight Company, has landed on Nakadia. Their objective is to destroy the planet's factories used to turn farm crops into armor-grade polymers used by the Empire. An Imperial company of stormtroopers, supported by a platoon of AT-STs, have set up defensive positions near one of the factories. The Rebel troops are positioned and ready to attack the factory garrison with a decisive frontal assault. They will also be receiving reinforcements from two of the company's platoons that were sent to destroy a nearby radar facility. Alright guys, it's time to get the battle started, but before we click start, I thought we'd go through some of the Imperial positions that the Rebel forces from the 61st Mobile Infantry have to defeat and overcome in order to secure a victory today here on Nakadia. I'm super excited to see if that's gonna be possible. So, the Stormtroopers are slightly outnumbered, but they do have a lot of firepower. And they have the advantage of being the defender today, which means they're dug in and ready to receive the frontal assault. We have a platoon of AT-STs spread out. We've got two regular AT-STs on both of the flanks here on the left side of this. Well, it seems to be an aqueduct of some sort. And they have, in the most recent version of the mod, a turret gunner. It looks like he's crewing a Meduse, like a 50 cal, but it's some sort of laser weapon, so that's pretty cool. And down here in the center, a little bit further back, we have an AT-ST with rockets, so it's going to be exciting to see how that thing works. Six rockets on the side there and a rocket pod, so that'll be cool. Some interesting trenches and positions here that are quite hastily set up. I presume you could deploy like a concrete formation here using just some sort of lifter, and then you set up the sandbags by hand. Three of those trenches, so to speak. There's also some stormtroopers up here defending one of the factories. Right down here. And there's a landing pad that has to be cleared out. Here's just an Imperial shuttle. Very cool stuff. We also have some rebels up on the high ground that are going to be advancing up and then to the right to potentially clear out this facility. But we'll see if the Twilight Company can win this today. About 40 men or so, 30 to 40 rebel troops are on their way here as we speak. But the frontal assault will begin before the Imperial Stormtroopers can receive reinforcements of their own, so to speak. But the reinforcing rebels will be arriving shortly, but the rebels will be engaged with the Stormtrooper garrison before that happens. So, good luck to both teams today. I'm going to make sure we take a look at the minimap. We'll have the Stormtroopers in blue and the Rebels in blue now. And, of course, the enemy in red. So, we'll click out of that. We'll remove the HUD. I'm going to remove the minimap as well. We don't want that thing popping up in the center of our screen. And we're going to go ahead and click Start. And to get the battle started, I'm going to select one of the attackers. I'm going to select this little gun. And, actually, we might as well get someone with a slightly longer range, because we do want to shoot at the enemy to start the battle. And then it'll all kick off. The frontal assault is underway. Some of the stormtroopers are kind of moving out with the AT-STs to provide some ground support. And they're going to be... well, they've got a lot of stormtroopers back in defense. I see some scout troopers coming up there as well, stationed on the island. Or not the island, sorry. The planet, of course. Been doing a lot of island invasions recently, and right off the bat, the rebel assault is like pushed back. They did take a lot of ground early from their starting positions, but they're pushed back because they didn't expect the AT-STs to come out and greeting them on the field. They thought they were probably going to hold back, and right now the rebel forces are taking a lot of fire. All three AT-STs are moving out, but there's a rocket. And it hit it, and it tipped over, but it exploded. The AT-ST is down. Some of these stormtroopers have to pull back now. Taking a lot of fire here. Still two AT-STs, rather, positioned in the center, putting down some serious fire on the rebel forces that are ultimately forced to retreat. A lot of the rocket fire going out, which is just absolutely demoralizing. Rebel forces from the Twilight Company now moving back, opening up a lot of fire there on the advancing AT-STs. We have some stormtroopers supporting, staying a little bit further back though. Made it up to some sort of rock side here where they can find some temporary cover before they ultimately have to advance at the enemy again. Another AT-ST is hit and it's down. Only one remain. Maybe the rebel forces can push out of this position. They've been taking a lot of suppressive fire, and it looked like it was kind of almost over early on. But a lot of rebel forces remain, and they have about 40 men on their way to reinforce, so this is going to be quite interesting. This ATST is just positioned out here without any real support. And I think it's rather foolish to think that the rebels have been defeated so early on. And there we go. The armor has been dealt with, and the rebel forces can now more or less quite comfortably defeat the defeat the defending stormtroopers. We have a section of scout troopers that were previously stationed on the planet, not an island quite, this time around, that are going to be arriving up here to support the heavily armed stormtroopers. So they're going to be fighting the rebels on this side. It's a little bit more open on the right side. We have another section of scout troopers who seem to have met their death in front of the rebels there, and they're just going to be trying to hold it down as good as they can. Some interesting stormtrooper positions back here, being able to put a lot of fire at the enemy. Four of them, actually. Four, quite interestingly, set up ad hoc defensive positions. And the rebels are, like, pushing up and pushing back. We'll see how it goes. It's a little bit back and forth on both flanks. And we have another section of scout troopers all the way back here that are going to be supporting the ad hoc positions in front of them, so that'll be quite interesting. There's also an elevated position up here where some of our rebels have moved up. They're supposed to clear out the factory, and I'm more or less playing as the attackers always. That's kind of like a ground rule, so I'm not gonna give them too many direct directives other than move your ass. You can't be sitting there wasting time. You have allies down below that are currently in fight, so you need to move up and at least take the fight to the enemy. There's a grenade thrown over the wall, but it got stuck on the door frame, so to speak. So hopefully this will involve the rebel forces on this side with the factory itself. There are quite a few stormtroopers defending, and there seems to be some sort of control center up here that the rebels would really like to disable and at least capture. On the field, not too much progress. I think the four or five platoons already deployed are waiting for another two to just arrive from the 61st Mobile Infantry so that they can indeed continue the attack. Some scout troopers moving up here as well. More stormtroopers are arriving up here at this cliffside. Perhaps that's a good idea to take the fight to the enemy, to hold them back from the defenses back here. Because if these defenses do indeed get outflanked, the stormtroopers defending are going to be rather helpless, because the terrain around them is rather tricky to defend against. There's a lot of vegetation, a lot of terrain differences. They're kind of out there in the open, so it's not the best ad hoc positions. Perhaps the stormtrooper company commander can explain himself later to some angry general for why they almost lost, or perhaps did lose, the factory. We'll have to find out who takes the victory. More rebel forces are getting to the high ground here, but then they're pulling back a bit. It's a little back and forth. They might be underestimating the Imperial strength early on. Here's one of the drivers from an ATST, and he's taking a lot of fire, and he's ultimately gonna get gunned down. The rebels are receiving a radio signal. The two platoons have been successful in destroying the radar facility and have taken minor casualties and will be arriving to support the rebel assault. A handful of squads of rebel troops have arrived now, and they're gonna be adding to the frontal assault here. So far, the rebels have been doing pretty good, but they haven't really been able to cross beneath the aqueduct to attack the stormtrooper-held positions. And right now, they are taking a lot of fire, but they're also putting a lot of fire on the attacking rebels. Seems to be a little bit back and forth. Very interesting. And some of the more frontal Imperial positions are still active, but many stormtroopers aren't actually back in the official cover. Perhaps these people were part of that counterattack that the stormtroopers initiated early on in the battle, but that was obviously put to a halt as they lost their armor support. Some of the scout troopers are still active back here. There's been a bit of a grenade fight between the rebels and stormtroopers. Both have died on both sides of this cliffside. The rebel seems to be working in squads now to put more efficient firepower on the enemy. They're staying more combined. They're moving up together, and they're acting as squads. No greater progress made up here. There's still stormtroopers inside the facility. Ultimately, the objective of the rebels up here is to secure the top ground. There's not much point in trying to help them down below. That fight is out of their hands. They need to really succeed at this point. If they cannot, then they will not be able to secure the factory itself. They'll have to commit more men up here to take it down. So I'm going to go ahead and give them the clear and direct objective of getting there and getting the job done. Taking a lot of fire, though, from the defending stormtroopers. Look at the sheer amount in there. Everyone's getting shot at. Grenades are being thrown. More people are moving in. Covering fire's being given out. But to get through that main gate, it's going to be hard. There are more rebels here, but the stormtroopers are not willing to give that up. And to commit more men into the machine gun fire here that the stormtroopers have set up is going to be almost a nightmare. I think the rebels, if they can capture more of this planet, will simply have to strategically bomb this location, call in some Y-wings of some sort, and perhaps some X-wings, and drop some serious ordnance on that position to knock it out. They don't need to keep the factories for themselves. They don't work with this kind of the armor production that the Empire does. So these factories produce polymers and plastics and other synthetic resins to resins, or perhaps it's called, to use for their stormtrooper armor. The rebels don't quite roll that way. The armor doesn't exactly stop a blaster projectile anyway. So all the stormtrooper defenses right now are taking some serious fire from the advancing squads, but not much has happened. They're still holding it down. This side has been completely wiped out, so the rebels can quite calmly and collectively move up. And they're going to be taking the higher ground again. They have almost killed all of the stormtroopers on the other side. There's that one running around there. He seems to be rather confused. I think he doesn't want to get hit by his own friends on the other side as well, because everyone is right now shooting above his heads. More rebels getting to the top here. Ugh! He's just going to die over his friends there. Absolutely crazy. More rebels to the high ground. Oh. Gruesome stuff. Only a handful of rebel troops survived the attack on the factory itself. And they've made the judgment call and of pulling back. They're simply not going to go on with that. It's too heavily defended. They'll have to try that another time, or perhaps use some air support, so to speak, to bring down the defenders of that factory. So they're going to pull out and try and help their forces on the ground instead. So the firefight has been going on for quite some time now, and the rebels have definitely captured a lot of grounds here on the stormtroopers. Some troops are moving up on the right side. It seems to be men from the part of the attack on the factory itself that have made it down here. A lot more rebels sitting back here, crawling up, moving up in squads. They've made a lot more progress on this side. They have indeed taken out the defense on this side, but there are more stormtroopers in the remaining three trenched positions, or whatever you want to call them, the defensive positions, rather, to battle. And there's a whole section of scout troopers back here. And the scout troopers are well trained. They have received more training than the average stormtrooper, so they're better shots. They have a higher rate of survivability, so to speak. So it'll be interesting to see how the rebels are going to tackle them. Some rebel snipers back here, putting a lot of fire on the defenders on this side. A little squad. Not many remain from the attack that we saw come out of this direction just minutes ago. More rebels to the high ground. They're really dug in now. They've definitely captured it this time around. There's a scout trooper standing out here acting cool. I'm not sure what he's thinking. Is he scanning the perimeter outside the trenches just to see if any rebels have snuck up close? Does he know that there's plenty of rebel troops on his left side? Seems to have been this kind of odd ceasefire now for a second, but then it kicks off. I think everyone just stopped for a second after shooting at each other for like a good 10-15 minutes, thinking like, what the hell is going on? What are we doing? Is everyone dead? And then for someone just to open up again, it all kicks off in a bloody firestorm of blaster projectiles and stuff. A lot of rebels have made it up pretty close here. They have started taking casualties, that is the stormtroopers, in this trench here. Look at that fire just going right over their heads. more people are dying on this side as well. Time is of the essence, so the rebel commander has ordered a full-scale charge on the remaining positions. They have to take out the defenders and get out of here before the stormtroopers receive more reinforcements. They have to essentially capture the factory, and the surrounding areas before the stormtroopers can receive more reinforcements. To do so, they have to kill all the defenders. So they've decided to more or less drastically charge at the enemy, and it's working out. They are killing a lot of stormtroopers, but obviously they're losing a lot of men doing so. Some of the positions are quite nicely still defended. The one on the right side is very much active. Not a lot of stormtroopers are alive around them, though, but the people behind the sandbags and in cover are still very much alive and kicking. To storm over the smaller heights in front would be a suicide. They're going to try and crawl up, perhaps try and get closer, put more fire on the enemy that way. Sneaky, sneaky, perhaps use some marksmanship. A lot of rebels grouped in the center now. They're going to be taking a lot of fire. Even the scout troopers behind them are opening up. They're getting closer to the stormtroopers. And one of the scout detachments back here are right now providing a lot of covering fire. The rebel forces could not defeat the defending stormtroopers in time, and two platoons of fresh stormtroopers have arrived to defeat the attacking rebels, or at least try to. And the rebels have made the call to pull back. They do not have enough manpower by this factory to fully secure it. They'll have to deal with it in other ways possible, potentially, of course, attacking it from the air if the anti-air defenses are weak enough, so to speak. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys soon again. Bye.